What is going on, everybody? Nasdorachi coming back at you again today for just a very quick update video for Dragon Ball Legends. I did want to keep y'all informed on the development of the situation at hand with how damaged the game has become since the introduction of version 2.2. I made a video about it a couple days ago, basically talking about it then, and still to this point in time, there has been no definitive fix for the people that are having trouble logging into the game, being able to play, period, or it's saying error transfer, you can't transfer your data over for some erroneous reason. They did fix the shop and the summons first, hilariously enough, with version 2.3, but we are expecting a hopeful version 2.4 here soon that will rectify the issues with data and network and connectivity and all of the game-breaking problems that have been recently introduced. I've honestly been taking the game a little bit slower, taking a break, and using this opportunity to play a lot of other games while there's a lot of down-tempo going on in Legends. So hopefully they do get that fixed, and we are here to update you. So it's been like a total of 144 hours since the game has been down. Wanted to bring up their official social media real quick just to show that 1 hour ago, they officially posted update on the CR990504 error. We have identified the cause of the login error and are now preparing a solution. We deeply apologize for the inconvenience caused and thank you for your kind patience and understanding while we resolve this issue. And Goresh, of course, killing it in the replies with a giant picture of Chrono Crystal. So basically what this is the login error that's causing problems with data, with network, with Wi-Fi, with connectivity to the game. It has been, again, about 6 days, almost 144 hours since this problem first developed. And that leads us to another little discussion about compensation, which we can have in a minute. But again, hopefully there'll be the version 4.3 coming soon, and everyone that's still having problems will be able to get into the game. Now, we have seen in the past for the 17-hour maintenance. We talked about this in the Dokkan & Legends Ultimate podcast. If you guys didn't catch that, it's every Saturday. But for that 17-hour maintenance, we were compensated 1,000 Chrono Crystals, if me and Goresh both remember correctly. So the game, again, 144 hours of downtime for a majority of the player base. And even if those people are not, you know, a majority of the overall players, it still affects the rest of us because there's less people in PvP, the co-op is harder to match with, there's just problems, lag, and connectivity issues, people disconnecting, you don't know if people are cheating or not in some cases, so there's been a lot of problems. So hopefully they do reimburse us for this issue in some way. Like, I'm not trying to come at this from an angle of, like, we deserve it, but hopefully, just based off of past iterations of issues and stuff like that, they do decide to reward us a little bit for the issues. Because again, it's kept me almost entirely off the game for the majority of the past like 4 or 5 days. Again, I've just been taking the time to play some other stuff and have fun doing some other video games that I may or may not end up making content for. But that's beside the point. I do want to know down in the comments, what are your guys' thoughts on compensation? What do you think would be fair? What would you like to see? I'm assuming we'd get at least like 1500 CC at the very minimum, but something that I suggested that I would love to see is a Legends Limited ticket that you could choose, basically like the one that came in that anniversary bundle for $80, but maybe it offers a choice. Just like pick one Legends Limited character. They don't have to give us any Chrono Crystals and mess with that in the server side to, you know, give everyone that. I'm sure that would probably be better for them because the value of this Legends Limited ticket's pretty high, but they're extremely hard to come by. Just getting one of them isn't going to make or break the game experience because you need so many dupes. So I thought that would be a good idea. But again, down in the comments, let me know what you think would be good compensation for the player base and something realistic. Like, obviously they're not going to give us all like 10,000 Chrono Crystals, but something realistic that you think would be good compensation. That's pretty much it for the news of the game. There's not too much going on. Again, version 2.2 destroyed everything. Then 2.3 coincidentally brought the shops and the summons back up first. And then they, I guess, just had more problems dealing with this CR990504509020 error. So I don't know what to say. It's not a huge development team at DIMS. They probably have like some, you know, corner office with like 15 to 30, 40 of them that work on this game, and then the majority of the DIMS employees are working on other projects. So I can well assume how problems like this can happen. Again, I don't hold it against them, nor am I demanding some sort of compensation, but again, just based off the past, it would be nice to see something like that. Other than that, you guys, I will keep you updated. We are still anticipating the Sin Shenron, the Baby Vegeta, and potential Valentine's Day stuff. I don't know if you guys were watching this either, but the World Grand Finals of the Dragon Ball FighterZ Tour just finished today, like earlier today in terms of when I'm recording this, and Goichi was the victor, and right after they showed off like Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku and Kefla for FighterZ, and Kefla's coming first this month because, you know, Valentine's Day, so I wonder, you guys, we have Valentine's Day incoming. We might very well see that before the Sin Shenron and Baby Vegeta banner. I would love to see Kefla, but again, let me know what your thoughts are on what you'd like to see for Valentine's Day down below, and what you think some compensation could be for these errors. Outside of that, that's pretty much it for today, you guys. I also did want to give a shout out to Ed, King of Games. Apparently his father's not feeling too well, so be sure to give him some love if you interact with him on social media at all. He's definitely a good dude, and hopefully his dad comes out strong. Outside of that, I know we kept it a little short this time, but I'll be back again very soon when the information and the game starts to pick back up, you guys. Remember, it is still quarter one. The game is like slowly accelerating. They don't want to compete with Dokken in its fifth anniversary too much, so I do anticipate that Valentine's Day and into March, we'll start to see some pretty big changes for the game. And of course, I'll be here to keep you all updated. Like the video if you enjoyed it. Help spread it out on YouTube. I appreciate each and every one of you that support it. And if you're new around here, consider subscribing, and we'll catch you on the next one. Peace out, y'all.